Okay, put it over here. There we are. Hello, and welcome to the second week of Well Served, our special cookery fortnight. Last week we were tasting foreign delights in our London studio, but this week we're out and about with our outside broadcast cameras. Well, you've already seen that I'm here with Mary Berry. Hello, Mary.
Hello, Judy.
And actually we're in Buckinghamshire at a picnic site which is owned by the local authority, and it's one of many that's springing up in many parts of the countryside, giving a rather continental look to everything. Well, today, as you can see, it's picnic time, really, and Mary is very busy at the moment unpacking a sort of family picnic, isn't it?
That's right, Judy. This picnic is one that you could freeze if you wanted to, and it all goes in one bag, the sort you might take on a train or in a nice Jeep that we've got.
And we've got a special occasion one, and then we're going off to have a barbecue, which will be smashing. You may be interested to know that we're producing a recipe leaflet with one recipe from each of the programmes in the special cookery fortnight. So at the end of the programme, after you've seen us cooking away at our barbecue, I'll be giving you the address to which to write to, so you may like pencil and paper. Right, let's see what you suggest for a family then in a picnic, Mary. I'm very interested in this. We go on a lot.
Well, sandwiches, Judy, with certain fillings like scrambled egg and ham and pate, freeze beautifully, and I usually freeze them in a packet like this. This one says Thomas and William no mustard, in fact, but I freeze them in a packet like that, then take the crusts off and pack them for the picnic like this. And so you can do it a week ahead, so you can have various fillings, and I've got some rolls here that have got layered fillings in.
It's always very handy, actually, to have those in the freezer, I would think. Then they'd last some good long time.
Yes, up to a month. Mm. And I usually fry chicken legs, which, again, you can freeze if you want to. And the chicken legs, I always put a piece of foil at the end so that you don't get your hands all sticky. And I fry them before I go on the picnic. And then I always think it's a good idea to take fresh fruit in season. Buck's cherries are
just
coming.
But in an individual little pot, like that, that's a good idea.
Isn't it more fun? I can't ever get my children to sit down, and they walk round eating a pot, which I think is much more fun. And then, on this particular picnic, I've made some mousses, just ones made from evaporated milk, but the children just love them, and you can freeze them.
And using those containers from other things that you've bought,
yes, these were bought mousses at one go. Also, I've got some fresh lemon drink here, and that's icy cold. And I always do coffee, because my husband and I like it. And I just take boiling water, because coffee's jolly expensive at the moment, and so I just make up the cups as we want it. And then if there's any coffee left over, I just take it home. Mm. And I take sugar separately.
What else have you got in here? I'm holding a fair amount.
Well, I've got just light mugs for the drinks and glass ones for the cold drink, which is nice. And I haven't... This is just an ordinary bag, and because I wanted things kept cold, I've lined the bottom with newspaper, just plain newspaper, and then I put these cold ice blocks in the bottom too, and that keeps... I put the sandwiches at the bottom, and that kept it really nice and cold. And then for sticky faces, always remember to take a cloth.
Absolutely, yes.
I don't know why, we'd have cherries all around here. And then for the rubbish, just a shoe bag that I can put all the rubbish in and take it home. We won't leave litter in the country, will we?
I'm very glad you said that. It's an essential part of any
and
picnic.
The last item is milk. I like real milk in coffee, so I always take it with me. You could use dried milk if you preferred.
Amazing warm it in that bag, eh? But let's go and have a look now at the special occasion picnic.
Mm.
Looks very good, isn't it? What have you got then for the special occasion?
Iced Spanish soup. That's what we did on the last programme together, Judy.
Gazpacho.
Gazpacho. Mm. And it's ideal for a picnic because you can have it icy cold, and you notice the ice is coming out as well. And you serve it with peppers and croutons. I've got in these containers. And then to follow, a lovely pie.
Gosh, that looks good.
Let's not drop it. You can just move that.
Yep.
It's a homemade chicken.
That looks delicious.
Shall I cut into it?
By Jove, that's a healthy portion. Who's going to have that?
I don't get the... Can you see the egg?
Oh,
that was lucky, wasn't it?
Now, that is included in the recipe leaflet, isn't it? All the details of how to do that and what's in it.
Chicken and ham, yes. Mm. And then, after you've had that, you have a bit of salad. And I always put the dressing in a glass container, then you just shake it. And a screw top jar. Everything I label, because if other members of the family are picking it up, they're not quite sure what it is. And then strawberries after that, real strawberries. Again, about fruit in season. and they're just becoming a bit more reasonable now.
And you've got wine, which is super, of course, and you've bought glasses. Now, that's something I do if I take wine, I must say.
Well, I think when you go to the luxury of having wine, it's nice to have it out of a glass.
Well, you needn't think any of this is going to be wasted. It's been promised to the crew for all a long, long time.